Roland Scholten was hitting the ton pluses for fun in his match against Chris Mason. 48 ton plus score lines, including 10 180s in that match. What sort of mood is he in tonight? He's with Helen.
So, Roland, you're playing Wayne later, yep. Who, as we know, is a very jolly guy. He comes on, he has his walk on and a little disco dance. Now, on the contrary, you appear to be a very serious man. Is that the case, or are you just totally focused on what you have to do?
Both, I think. I'm trying to keep Wayne quiet because that gives him confidence, and that's something you don't want to give your opponent, do you? So, in that respect, I'm focused and, yeah, I'm quite serious when I'm up there. It's my work.
And the game that you had with Chris Mason, it was tit for tat, and it was battle of the doubles as well. Is that something you got? I know that you've only had one day off, but will you go away and maybe work on your doubles a little?
Oh yeah, I've been practicing for a few hours on my doubles and things like that, and hopefully it'll all come together tonight.
I think it's going to be a bit of a ding-dong match tonight.
I hope not. I hope you're definitely wrong, because I don't like ding-dong matches. I prefer to win straightforward, and that's it.
Yeah, but we do. We're the viewers. We like to see a good scrap.
I don't care. This is my profession. This is what I want to do. I want to finish it off ASAP.
Okay, well, we'll all be watching. Thank you very much for talking to us. Good luck.
Thank you very much.
What about his opponent then? Wayne Mardle put out Mark Dubridge, still, of course, looking for that first televised title. Speaking of Helen.
Wayne, big first game against Mark Dubridge. Could you relax and enjoy it at all, or were you always on your toes?
No, I didn't play particularly well, but Mark was even worse than I was. So we were waiting for each other. So as for enjoying it, no. This game I'm intending to enjoy.
You know what you're going to get with Roland, don't you?
Well, you do. You know he's going to hit loads of 180s, loads of big scores, but he can miss a few doubles, which obviously I never do. So...
you could say that with a straight face.
Well, I tried. But no, it's going to be a lot of scores, a couple of missed doubles, but it still takes their chances.
And do you look a step further? Because after this in the draw, it's either Phil Taylor or Kevin Painter. Do you even allow yourself to think that far, or this game and this game only?
No, it is this game, literally. When I played Mark in the first round, I never even considered playing Roland in the second game, so I don't really care about them. Whoever wins out of them is good for them, but yep. I don't really care.
Okay, it's all about your game. All right, thanks very much, Wayne. Good luck.
Thank you.
Well, looking forward to this really good evening of darts, and tomorrow night, don't forget, Raymond Van Barneveld, Phil Taylor, both in action in the evening session. Let's crack on then with our MC, John McDonald.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the action here in Blackpool. Second round, the best of 25 legs, and time to meet the players. Would you please welcome all the way from Den Haag in the Netherlands, former UK Open champion, the Flying Dutchman, Roland Scholten!
Entertainer, but will he need a life raft after this one? We'll wait and see. as round two begins at the match play in Blackpool. Best of 25 legs, your commentary team now, John Gwynn and Dave Lanning.
Yes, a fascinating contrast in styles. Wayne Mardle flamboyant, Roland Scholten phlegmatic, and Mardle with his usual modest, understated entry onto the stage. And it's party time in Blackpool. Darts, the sport with the feel-good flavour. And we're into the second round, and it could be better poised, John.
You're dead right, Dave. Always brings a smile to the stage, that's for certain. Wayne Mardle hasn't, over the last 12 months, 18 months, always left the stage with the same smile. But all the signs are from his round one defeat of Mark Dudbridge, when, on his own admission, he didn't throw particularly well, but he did hit the necessary big finishes, five of them. This guy, of course, the hitter of the big 180s, Dave.
Yes, he does punch his weights in Roland Scholten as far as scoring is concerned. It's just that he has these occasional days when, well, he has, as they say, a bad egg for breakfast and just doesn't seem to perform. If it's one of those nights, then Mardle should have a fairly easy trot.
But if
Scholten really in the mood, then we're going to have a closely contested battle. There's only one place between them in the rankings. Mardle's 8, Scholten's 9. 60. So it should be a close call.
Yes, everything points to that. Of course, first to 13 now, given that there's two legs or more difference 93. At that stage. And sit back and enjoy what should be an enthralling contest. We've had so many in the first 3 days of this wonderful tournament here in Blackpool.
96.
And this could be up there amongst them as one of the best.
Yes, they're all turning out to see Wayne Mardle. He's such a popular character, chirpy and cheerful, like the classic Blackpool landlady.
60.
Well, it was here on his appearance back in 2003, Dave, if you remember. They suddenly started producing these shirts on the seafront, and they were going 100. Rather more quickly than they could produce them.
He has, as Bertie Wooster would say, a sunny disposition, whereas this man, Roland Scholten, has about as much emotion
140.
As a Red Indian outside a barbershop.
145. Oh, what a great start that would have been. Mardle hits the 180 to put him on a finish. Scholten almost takes out 145.
Double 18. He loved it over here to win the first leg against the darts. And that could be an important miss. It's early doors yet. But Mardle had the opportunity of first blood. Now Scholten double 10. Now double 5. Doesn't worry him up here. Wide in his eye line.
Inside the first leg. Roland Scholten.